Hi, my name is Jonathan Collin. I have worked at Darewise Entertainment as a senior animator on the futuristic social adventure game called Life Beyond. In this video, I present some of the animation systems I developed in Unreal Engine to try and support the large scope of the game with only few animators. For on-ground locomotion, we only animated the character moving forward and backward. If the player strafes sideways, we rotate the character in the movement direction and use look-at poses to make them look towards the camera. With this technique, we can dynamically change at what angle the character switches between forward and backward, depending if the player is aiming their weapon or not, without any additional animation. Because we only animate two directions, we could afford to make banking cycles if the player moves in a curved trajectory. For starts, however, we cover a large number of angles, but we only did it for walking. If the player runs, the start walk animation is played faster to eliminate foot sliding. We then play an additive leaning animation on top to sell the momentum. To make the character move believably on a bumpy terrain, we first determine the average slope angle. We create two line traces around the character in front and behind. This is enough to get a pitch and roll values, which will drive additive poses that serve as a first approximation to adapt our flat cycles to the terrain. We use that approximation for replicated characters. For the local player character, we go one step further and actually create line traces under each foot. We additively lower or raise each foot to connect them with the floor. If the character is standing, we lower the hips with the same offset as the lowest foot. If the character is crouching, we consider the highest foot. We then align each foot to the floor. We thus have different results on staircase and slopes. Finally, we play additive leaning poses when the slope angle suddenly changes, giving a better feeling of awareness. We created an advanced layer system to let the character play a wide variety of interactions on the upper body, like holding weapons, reloading, aiming, or striking different stances based on their emotion. All our locomotion is animated with no weapon held in the hands. The arms move freely. We call it no-gun. In the no-gun animations, however, we do have a joint moving freely, and we attach the weapon onto that animated joint when it's actually equipped. The arm's motion is then overridden, and the hands are snapped onto the weapon. The system can attach or detach the arms independently, depending if the weapon is one- or two-handed, or if the character needs to perform a gesture. The layer system then takes care of offsetting the weapon joint motion to match any kind of stance. The challenge was to support poses that feature different feet width, without introducing foot sliding when switching between weapons while in idle, or when going between idle and moving. Our locomotion features two sets of transitions, one for the narrowest pose and one for the widest pose. These poses are called core poses. We made sure that every weapon pose had the feet positioned somewhere in between these two core poses, these two extremes. For weapon switching, we created four shuffle-in-place transitions: narrow to wide, wide to narrow, wide to wide, and narrow to narrow. A blend space allows us to select any possible transition from any weapon stance to any other weapon stance. When aiming in third person with the shoulder camera, there is often a disconnect between where the crosshair tells you you're going to shoot and where the bullet actually goes when aiming walls at close distance, for example. This is due to the parallax between the gun's position held by the character and the camera, which is offset. To solve it, we had to make a series of line traces starting from both the player and the camera, and detecting if there was a collision nearby, and offset the player animation accordingly to make the bullet reach the crosshair. The combat system features directional hit reactions called flinches. We have 5 different animated directions: front, front left, front right, back left, and back right. We first determine where the target has been shot, using a simplification of the body into 5 parts: lower body, torso, head, and left and right arms. We determine an angle between the point of impact and the line of the shoulders to play the most accurate reaction, regardless if the posing of the target character is a bit sideways compared to the capsule, which is often the case with combat postures. Hence, if the shooter is standing on the front right of the character and aim for the left shoulder, the target plays a hit reaction that actually feels like they were shot from the left and not from the right. To animate complex mechanical pieces, we export a 1-second long animation that represents the full range of motion. For example, for the hover bike, we exported a pitch and a scratch animations, and controlled by different values such as the vertical speed or the acceleration, we created spring effects without having to create lots of animations. We actually used the same range of poses on the character. This gives more control over the action than if we were just exporting the first and last pose and let the engine blend in between.